Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. what does it take to create beauty out of pain? I've known my share of grief. Sometimes I get the emotion, brooding on a painful, tempering sorrow, until a voice in me says, stop. And I listen. I pick up my instrument, and I channel that firm, untarnished voice into an invisible musical body that envelops your ears, reaches into your heart, and reminds you that the same sweet voice, as unique as you, is also in you. My young cats, yeah, you my horses, you know. If you can't look inward and beyond, hear the muse speaking, singing, dancing, and know yourself as but a servant, then I'll send you back, kick you in the guts to remind you where the music starts. Put aside your desires and be willing to suffer anything to create something beautiful. Do this, and you can share my stage. Circle around my need for others and my fear of being too vulnerable. So I come back to the music. What else can transcend this pain and harsh world that I feel so acutely, as if the world is my own body? Secure myself by taking up the role I've been given and play it without compromise. And there I find the key to play it. You know, to play heartbreak, remorse, joy, love, loss, all the colors of darkness and light. And through my time-crafted instrument, my body's longtime companion. I screech my pain yearnings. I giggle my delights. I give the depth and intensity that is in me a form and an expression through the improvised play of music. So that you can feel it too.
Thank you. We'll be right back.
Up here.
Is that better? Can y'all hear me?
See if this is fall on me.
We had a thank you, Raphael. We had a circumstances of our climate. We had a couple COVID incidents. So besides thanking this band, I need to thank Allison and Bunky Corrigan, who is our conductor today. They stepped in last minute and did a wonderful job. I'd like to thank Mike Reed and the Constellation staff for having us. Mike's been doing a great job. How about a hand for Mike Reed and the hard work that he does. I must thank D-Case for helping me fund this project, and also WDCB for their sponsorship. I'd also like to thank Matthew Golombisky at Ears and Eyes label for doing a little label and making a bunch of music happen. I would also like to, I really need to thank the Jazz Institute who helped us put this project together in 2018. But actually, I also need to thank Lauren Deutsch, who's not here tonight, but she actually came up with this idea for me to do something like this back in 2011, and we had a trail run in Poznan, Poland, and then she pushed me to do this in 2018. So a lot of this work that I did was a combination of what I did at University of Chicago, and I want to thank my advisors, Travis Jackson, Phil Bowman, and I'm not sure if Travis is here, but I know William Seitz is here. I don't know if you've read his recent Sun Ra book, but you should read it. I definitely have to thank George Freeman, who not able to be here today, but George, I can't tell you how many hours I've spent with him the past few years to help me think about a lot of this. One of the people who had to cancel was my brother Brian, unfortunately, but Brian is the one who put together the astrology that helped me compose this piece, and he also wrote the text so eloquently read by Bill Bricky. So. That was Brian's astrological interpretations of Vaughn's life. I definitely have to thank my wife Maria for helping me out a lot to get through all this, besides trying to balance teaching and playing. Brought lunch yesterday for the rehearsal, so that was great. I also would like to announce, I'm not so sure, Lady Jean is in the house tonight, Jean Payne. She's an old friend of the Parliament Lounge. She informed me that Mr. Barnes, I don't know if you guys heard this, Mr. Barnes passed away last month, who was the owner of the Parliament Lounge. So I'd like to mention that. Of course, I have to thank Mark and Chico Freeman, Von Sons, for, you know, being close, good friends and advisors. And also, I should mention that on June 23rd, Chico is going to be in town, and this entire horn section is going to be part of the band. It's going to be 19-piece orchestra with D. Alexander. That's going to be playing a bunch of new music that Chico wrote, what he's calling a legacy project about the South Side and his family. So make sure you get to that. You can find out more about this project and how it all came together on a website that I designed called vonology.info. And then, of course, I have one more thing. I have to thank Von Freeman. It was 10 years ago this coming August that we lost Von. And I know all of us in here miss him like crazy, especially the trio. Me, Matt, and Michael Rayner played with him for a very long time every Tuesday. And when we play together, we're like, you know, Mike lives in Portland. He comes to town, and we're like, oh, yeah, we used to play together all the time, and it feels so great every time. So spirituality is very important for Milan. And I have to say something from my heart because I'm really pissed off. I'm pissed off about guns. I'm pissed off about parents who lose their children to guns unnecessarily. I'm pissed off that the right wing has taken over the discourse of guns. There should be universal background checks. Assault weapons should be banned. That is absolute nonsense. The past, 30 school shootings have been with an AR-15. Fuck that shit. Okay? I'm taking a stand because I'm pissed. You know, Marie and I sit at home and we think that could have been Gebby, could be our niece. It could be any friend's kid. And it's all because of some whack-ass idea that you have to have some liberty with guns? What the fuck? So I'm pissed off. I apologize for the language. But what we need to do is we need to, even if we have differences, we need to heal. And it's really, really, really hard to do in these times, especially pandemic. Ridiculous political discourse that's going on right now. So we're going to take a moment and we're going to channel Vaughn, because I'd originally chose this next piece because I knew Vaughn, this was important for Vaughn, but I also think it'll help us maybe kind of think, like, let's try to get this solved, let's heal, and let's change some shit, because it's got to get changed.
To the
precious Lord.